Well, new at 6, another one of those stories that will make you say, what will the criminals think of next? Women buying positive pregnancy tests online, then extorting money from men.
That's right. Women are selling sticks with plus signs on the website Craigslist for as low as $25 a pop. WREG's Adam Hammond explains how it works.
I'm pregnant. It's a phrase that can change your life in a second, and women all around the country are telling men that very phrase, but the problem is, it's a lie. The story's exploding online, saying women are lying, showing someone else's positive pregnancy test they bought online to trick a man into marrying her. Divorce attorney Miles Mason says that's fraud.
In my opinion, that type of evidence of a false pregnancy test to induce to marry should result in an annulment.
A different trick women are using the positive pregnancy test for is to extort money out of men by making them think they're financially responsible for a baby.
At that point, I would say take a deep breath, don't react one way or the other, and say, well, that's interesting.
Genetics experts like Steve Kahn say if you hear that news, the first thing you should do is buy a high-quality pregnancy test for that woman or bring her to a DNA testing center where they can find out for sure if she is pregnant.
That leaves out the internet. It leaves out concerns over falsified urine, substituted urine.
It may seem wrong, but Mason says it's perfectly legal.
It's the same thing as selling a used Q-tip. I mean, it may not necessarily be something somebody wants, but if somebody's willing to pay for it, there's nothing inherently illegal about selling a pregnancy test result.
Kahn disagrees and thinks they should make it illegal because people are committing crimes with the tests.
The sale of it, I think, sure, should come right off Craigslist or eBay or wherever they're being sold. I mean, they regulate other things. You can't sell child pornography, for instance.
In Memphis, I'm Adam Hammond, WREG News Channel 3.
Kahn says pregnancy tests aren't the only thing being sold online. People are also selling their urine for others to use for pregnancy tests or drug tests.
Plenty of expecting moms hoping to cash in on their condition by selling positive pregnancy tests to anyone who is willing to pay up.
If it's a prank, it would be hysterical, but it can be really cold-hearted and mean.
Tricking a man into marrying them, or at the very least trying to keep a partner in a relationship he no longer wants any part of.
I think that would be, you know, a level of blackmail.
That's playing with people's emotions. That's a real-life situation. You don't mess with stuff like that.
Cons are no good, and it never results in anything positive.
How cruel is this? Positive pregnancy tests are being sold online. Some women are buying them to trick or trap men. Man, this is crazy. The Dream Team back, and they join me now about this. Susan Hendricks, of course. Darren, I have to start with you. You know it was coming. What is this, Darren? What have we become as a society?
Yeah, well, you know, Joey, honesty, candor, these are the values that are at the foundation of any successful relationship. So, of course, a marriage that's entered into based on a fraudulent pregnancy test that's been obtained online,
it's gonna last
that
a long
relationship
time.
Not headed for the rocks, is it? No, this is crazy. But, you know, the craziest part of it is not that there is a market where women are selling them. The thing that's insane to me is that there's such a demand for them. Apparently, this is a pretty hot item. I've been going on eBay to check it out.
I may be buying one just as a souvenir. Don't get any ideas, Kevin Oakey. Susan, this is just a mess, though.
I couldn't believe this was actually real, that women, first of all, are selling them. Other women are buying them. And by the way, the guy's going to figure it out eventually. We have some Facebook posts here. It says, if you start a relationship, this is from Tremont, offline, that's exactly what the whole relationship will be based on. Also, just because she said she's pregnant doesn't mean their partner will stay with them. And Lynn says, no law, all is fair in love and war. Lynn says, why not? What? And finally, William says, any man who falls for this is an idiot. Any woman who does this is simply pathetic and deserves to be with the idiot who fell for it. Look, the guy who falls for this, how would he ever suspect that this could possibly happen?
Especially when, as Darren says, the relationship is founded on trust and love and honesty.
Don't you want to be with the guy who wants to be with you?
You do. So, Seema, should we be going to court to get an injunction against these things so that these online pregnancy tests are a thing of the past?
Not just yet. And actually, I have to say, I was interviewed about this issue a few months ago. So it's been going on. It's getting to be a hotter topic. And here is why. The selling of the pregnancy test itself is not illegal. There's no action. However, if it is the basis
for someone to commit fraud, number one, for someone to enter into a contract based on fraud, then you have that pregnancy test coming into evidence. So, bottom line is, at some point in family court, shall we say, it could be a piece of evidence based upon this whole fraudulent.
Nothing good can come of this.
Nothing good, Susan. It's fraud in the first degree. Let's see what Dr. Drew had to say about this. He was pretty fired up, Susan.
I want to show you some of the ads on Craigslist right now. Here they are. Put them up. In Texas, $20. I don't want to know why you want or need it, but if you do, I will make it happen. I am pregnant, so it will be legit. We'll mail to any address or meet if nearby. Won't be available much longer. I guess there's a delivery date coming.
Wow.
So, Shagun, have at. Shagun, what say you?
Well, first of all, if we thought V. Stiviano was bad, like these women win the gold in the skank Olympics. And I just have to ask you, Dr. Wenny, who hurt you, dear? Because you always come on and you say that it's always tit for tat and like men do this to get by on women and it's only fair. But there are some things that are just dead wrong. And faking a pregnancy, selling urine, have we come to that? Is it so bad that we are now selling urine on Craigslist to trick a man into thinking you're pregnant to keep a man in a relationship?
But men trick women all the time.
Susan, how right was he?
He was right on it. Doesn't it sound like a Lifetime movie, the buying and selling of a fake pregnancy test? Don't do it.